Hey folks, Kevin here. Well, it's December 24th, 2019, and today I'm out back and I thought I'd share with you a project that I started working on yesterday afternoon. And that's laying some of the hardy cement boards, which are backer boards for, typically people use them for putting on top of a subfloor in their home and they want to put the tile on top of it. One of the great properties about these cement boards is that they're mold resistant, moisture and mold resistant. They're also fire resistant. Now, get into those properties that we'll be using the material for in the future in another video. But what I started doing yesterday was going ahead and starting to install those on the walls of the root cellar. Now, it's kind of tough because we have lots of canned goods down there. But it'll be a little bit snug down in that area, but I'll take you down there and I'll show you what we're doing. Okay, so I'm down here inside of the root cellar. The white styrofoam material here is the insulated concrete foam boards. Really good insulation, very waterproof. There's also a waterproof membrane on the outside of the building, perimeter drain at the base as well, that drains into one of the swales down further on the property. And typically you don't see 2x4s or woody structural materials inside of a basement like this or in this root cellar because there's no need for them in typical situations. However, because above this root cellar is the sugar shack, which there'll be many tons of fluid inside of this, I decided to do overkill. So the floor joists up above here are 2x12s with sandwiched with 2x6s as well. And I decided not only to have them sit on top of the 13-inch thick, 8 inches of concrete and the two layers of the insulation as well, I decided to build out some 2x4 studs on the inside of these two walls that support this and a central beam, triple laminated beam going right up there above as well with 6x6 pillars holding that up. Just because of all of the potential weight above, and I'll get into how we'll be constructing the floor up there in future videos. It'll take me quite some time at the rate I'm going here. But I used repurposed, recycled 2x4s. Most of these came from projects, buildings that I had over 30 years ago. Some of them came from a friend's house that he was remodeling and had mold in it. So I went through processes of killing the mold using Clorox, having them out in the sun, using vinegar, all of those things. And so all the mold organisms have been dead now for a couple years, but I did go ahead and coat it with some anti-mold treatment on the surface of it as well. But you'll see that there are some 2x4s that I'm installing down here as well. These studs that you see that are all white are all 16 inches on center. And one of the things we want to do is control our different environments down here in the root cellar because there's different requirements, moisture requirements for different storage. So now, right now we've got tons of canned goods in here, dehydrated goods as well. Lots of different materials that are in this one great room. And we'll end up modifying this into subunits in the future. But I always wanted to be able to manage this area because this is also a water management area. So this wall behind me here, there's pipes that come through and they go to different water totes on the property. It's going to be a central station for pumping the sap from the trees from different 275-gallon containers in different spots on the property. It'll come up through here, go through a reverse osmosis system and a whole bunch of things like that. So there could be potential leaks of moisture coming down to this area, and I never wanted to have to worry about mold being an issue. So no woody materials down here that will be exposed is the main goal, or be it minimal. So you see our shelving right here, this is all, oh, the stuff you get in a box store, plastic shelving and all. I'm going to be modifying that as well. But one of the things I'm going to do is be building shelves on this wall. Initially, I thought about putting shelves in between each one of these studs going up, and that would save us 3.5 more inches of room space. but I elected to use the hardy board. So at the base down here, I'm installing hardy board right now. So the reason that there's some uncoated 2x4s here is because these sheets, instead of being 4x8 sheets, which would be ideal for 16 on center 2x4s, I've gone ahead and had to put studs where the 5 foot long sheets will end. So yesterday I came in, put some additional studs in here, and started laying the first layer down. I've got to go ahead and pencil those out and get the screws in them, and then start getting the next layers up as well. So that's one of the projects I'm working on now. Ultimately, there'll be cement board all the way around here, and upstairs there'll be cement board on the floor surface as well. Because whenever you're doing wood-fired hearth where you're going to be heating up the sap and making maple sugar, there's always a possibility of a fire ember hitting the floor. And so having a non-flammable surface is really important. But back to this job. Well, it's been a couple of days. It's December 26, 2019, and I've gotten three of the walls with the fiber cement boards installed at this point. This is the north wall. This is the south wall. Got those two walls finished. I'm going to hold off on doing the west wall here for a while because I've got a lot of penetrations. This part here won't be difficult, but that side over there, I've got to turn off the water at another place on the property to those two systems there. And I don't know that I want to do that during the winter months. I may wait until, just in case there's a problem, I got to use the excavator to dig things up. So that still has to be done. But down here on the east wall, I did get the east wall fiber cement board up. So that's set. One of the next things to do is to start to create the three different zones in this root cellar. So in our zones, we need to have one zone that's relatively high humidity. Now all of these areas in the root cellar need to maintain a very cool temperature, around 50 degrees or potentially even less. And I'll talk about that in future videos, how I'll maintain lower temperatures in one of the zones. But we need to have high humidity in two of the zones. And this zone over here will be the high humidity zone for the root vegetables. So our carrots and potatoes, all of those will be going into a small section here, this area in here. And I need to remove this shelving unit so that I can put a partition that goes right across, right next to this 6x6 beam here, go right across the wall, put in a door system over there, and have two door systems going into this area, one for the entrance to get up and down the spiral staircase. Eventually there'll be a small material handling elevator that'll come down right in this space as well, not to carry people, but to help with heavy supplies, whatever it is. As we get older, we want to make it much easier for us to get food materials and canned goods in and out of here easily. Over in this section here will be another relatively high humidity zone with even increased ventilation in this area, because we can put our apples, those produce that actually produces a lot of ethylene that has to be evacuated from the system so that further maturation and potential spoilage of those fruity materials. So both this zone will be high humidity and that zone will be high humidity. This whole section over here will be low humidity, cold, well ventilated, and so that'll meet all the needs of all of our canned goods to keep them from getting rust on our tops, keep us from having problems with spoilage of our winter squashes down in this area as well. And we may keep some other materials, like we have, you know, some paper products and some cushions and all. And so anything above eye level here, I don't want to be putting canned goods up higher than that because it's more difficult to see and all. So ultimately, once this partition is put across here and I've got doorways planned for this, for once the doorways are all set up and all, and I'll have corners here, then I can decide on how the shelving units will go around down to that wall, the height that it'll go to. Now I could put light products if I wanted to put our cushions for our outdoor furniture, put them above here. Again, this would be a low humidity zone. And our canned goods, whether it's quarts, pints, whatever it may be. And then what I'll do down below, I still have to decide, but I don't want to be bending over and hurting ourselves trying to get to things, unless it's some of the crates that we put down there with some of the winter squash down in that area. So once I decide what the shelvings will be like, I'll decide on how the fans actually circulate the air in here, besides the cool air intake and exhaust and the warm air, moist warm air exhaust out of this system. So we'll have the entrance and exit air supply for each of these areas. And we'll also have an independent circulation system for each one of these zones. There will be humidifiers in the parts of the root cellar where we're going to be storing our root vegetables, as well as, and I'm not sure if I'll be doing a misting system or not, for some of the apples or the root zones as well. So this will be divided up into three areas. I'm not sure how far I'll get with this. I've got to pick up some more building materials. I got to search through and see what materials I've got for shelving, for lumber, for doors, all of those things. Everything's in storage in different places on the property, and I'll just have to dig through and see just what I've got. And of course, everything's weather dependent. So that's it for today's video. If you have any comments or questions or thought processes, please leave them in the description below. I'd really appreciate that. And if you found this video of value, please give us a thumbs up. I always appreciate that. Share it with your friends. And by all means, folks, have a super fantastic day. Bye-bye now.